Hey, welcome back to Kids Eye. So today we're going to talk about density. So density is how much something weighs per its volume. So density is usually measured in things like grams per milliliters. So a good way of talking about density, a good visual way of talking about density is mixing oil and water. So the first thing you want to know about oil and water is that oil is made of organics and it's immiscible, which means it doesn't dissolve in water. And water, I went over before, is made out of H2O, so it's very polar. So the oil is non-polar, polar, and the water is polar. So what I have here is just a regular glass. I have some oil in here, and I just have some water that I added a little bit of food coloring to. And you can see that as you add the water is heavier, so it's more dense, so it goes to the bottom of the oil. And you get something that looks a little bit like a lava lamp. Now, if you don't have a glass at home, you can use, like I have a pickle jar here, it's something you can use. And this is an old like spice container. But you just want to make sure that it's clear. So you can do the same thing with the spice container. Just rinse it out. And we're going to add our green food coloring to it. Yeah, green water with the food coloring to it. And you can see that the green goes to the bottom because, again, the water is heavier than the oil. And also, it's immiscible, which means that it won't go into solution together. So the oil is not going to dissolve again into the water, and vice versa, the water is not going to go into the oil. So here we have another one that's going to be kind of cool. So we're going to mix colors. So we have our blue here. And Jimmy poured, and the blue goes right to the bottom. So in our blue, we have some base, and if you go to the website, kidseye.org, there should be some information about acids and bases. And in the red jar, for the red cup here, I have some acid. So it's citric acid dissolved in water, and again, it's more dense than the oil, so it's going to go through the oil, but you can see that as it mixes, so as it mixes, it's going to react. And it'll keep slowly reacting until the blue goes away and the red goes away and it's all purple. So that's how you know this particular reaction will be complete. So it's kind of a cool way of just making cool way of mixing acids and bases to get a better understanding of a neutralization reaction. And it's the same principle used in making the volcano. That's a cool way of making like a little lava lamp. So it's kind of like a lava lamp. Let's see, you want to add a little bit more. Give it a little stir. Then you add your red to it. Or vice versa, base or acid. As long as they're both mixing together, you get a nice, cool looking reaction. And then you can see too, because you have the air bubbles that are going up, air is the least dense of all three. So the air is going all the way to the top. So the air is lighter than the oil and the water, so it's traveling through the aqueous layer here, past the oil layer, and out of the container. So you see the bubbles rising through? So on the internet, using soda and candy. So at the bottom, again, soda is aqueous, so it's mostly water. So it's gonna be below the oil. And when we drop the candies in, wow, absolutely not. It's supposed to react. There you go. Ah, here we are. We give it a little mix. And that's our Diet Coke and our Mentos in the bottom and the oil. And you're getting a bit more violent reaction than you get with the acid and the base. But again, we're using weak acids and weak bases because we're in the kitchen at home and not in our labs. And again, the gas that's formed is lighter than the aqueous layer and the organic layer. So the gas is gonna just travel through the aqueous layer, through the organic layer, and out into the kitchen. Okay, so I'm back. And that was our quick talk about density and acid-base reactions. So again, there was some citric acid dissolved in water and baking soda dissolved in water. And then we also have Diet Coke and Mentos for our Coke and candy experiment here. So remember, if you don't have glass cups, you can use the plastic cups. And if you don't have those, use what you have in your house. Old spice containers or pickle jars work just fine. Thanks for watching. Bye.